Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. I know it's been a while, but we are hopefully back and going to be doing a lot more of these walk around videos. They were quite well received before, so we thought we'd kick off with a couple of special cars. Right, so today we have got a JDM spec Impreza STI 2-litre engine. Those of you that don't know, these come with a 2-litre as opposed to the 2.5s that you get on a UK car. Twin scroll setup, wide track model, DCCD, pretty much standard apart from a splitter and what looks like a titanium Kakimoto exhaust. I don't know if it's a full system or not. I don't know if it's decatted or not. We'll have to check, but I think there's something in the downpipe. But other than that, fairly stock. It is in really, really nice condition. As you can see, probably arguably one of the most popular, a little bit of debris from the Surrey Hills there. Arguably one of the most popular shapes is the Hawkeye with the JDM engine, basically. So let's kick it off. Key facts, it's done about 108,000 kilometers, which is approximately 67,000 miles. It was imported in 2023, earlier this year. So it's pretty much a fresh import. One UK owner, and the underside is clean. So it's not been treated to the UK roads for a long period of time. You can see the paint just pops. Nothing really to report on the front. It really is in nice condition. This little tree stuff. That's from the tree. Obviously, we are known for doing quite a lot of Subarus, so they're not new to us, but we like ones that look like this, especially in the blue. Let's be honest, it's the color everyone wants with the gold wheels. It's got unfortunately the other side's cracked, but some really nice OEM or JDM should say wind deflectors there. Little mark there. Some sort of sticker residue or a little scratch on the spoiler there. That's the exhaust there. So I don't know if it's a titanium system or not. Obviously anyone who's seriously interested, we don't have our own workshop, but we can book it into a garage and get some underside photos. We'll do that anyway, because we know it's a question that's asked pretty much on every Subaru. Unfortunately, we get a lot of pine little bits and pieces from the trees up here. It was serviced as well when it came into the country, so it was serviced at 67,000 miles. Timing belt was done in Japan. I do have some Japanese history, so you can verify that, which is actually quite nice because you don't normally get any sort of history from Japan, but this actually has some. So I've got some Japanese bits. If you can read Japanese, you've got a couple of curb alloys. We can get these powder coated if need be. So not to worry, but it does look really, really nice. Let's show you inside. Rear pockets are really nice as well. We've checked them out, obviously. Seats are really nice and padded still. If you're watching this video, you don't need to know what these are worth now. Like, everyone knows they're going up. All that older generation, hence the Skylines sitting around, they're investments these days. So as long as you buy the right one, I think you're not going to really lose any money. I'm not giving you financial advice there, I'm just saying that I've been in and around these cars for over a decade now. Padding's nice. Steering wheel. Came with that from Japan. I'm going to source an original, well, just a normal STI steering wheel that you would get in this generation of car. So it will come with the correct steering wheel. I'm not going to sell it with just that. You can have both, but it will come with the STI steering wheel. Show you under the bonnet. those of you who've watched our previous videos will know we do not go jet washing our engine bays, so we show them quite raw. But you can see turrets are really nice. Even got the standard airbox there. Let's close that up. Right, I've got a key. I'm going to fire it up for you. It's a completely cold engine. Let's grab the right key because I had a Porsche key in my hand there. There we go. Right. There's no weird alarms or immobilizers. A complete cold start. It's not ridiculously loud. It actually sounds really, really nice, I think. Nothing intrusive. There's your DCCD. If I push the button there, you see it goes there and you can scroll through it. Let's be honest, no one ever uses it, but it's there. You've got UK radio as well for some reason. It picks up that FM bandwidth there. That's from Japan. It stays with the car, some sort of a dash cam there. I'm not gonna go rev it up completely. It is a cold engine. And there you go. All right, guys, all the information will be in the description below. If you've got any questions, please don't hesitate to get in touch and let me know if anyone's interested in that. That's my personal one, which is going up for sale soon. Factory manual R34 GTT. Get in the comments below if you want to see an advert and a video on that. Thanks for watching. Bye bye.